A pop-up is an overlay that stops on-site visitors and displays an informational or promotional message to grab their attention. Common types include exit intent pop-ups, which appear when a user is about to leave the site, discount pop-ups that promote sales, and special offer pop-ups featuring coupons. Pop-ups can be a powerful tool to boost conversions by up to 40% when paired with a compelling offer. Reduce abandonment rates by 10% to 15% from around 78.65% by offering an on-exit discount. Increase email list growth by 15% on average with an email opt-in pop-up. Welcome to FoxKit Tutorial by FoxEcom. In today's video, we'll walk you through the steps to set up a discount pop-up using the FoxKit Sales Boost app. This pop-up will help attract and engage customers, significantly increasing the chances of making sales on your website. To get started, make sure you have your FoxKit theme helper enabled to let the app work with your theme. Then, in your Shopify admin panel, navigate to Apps and click on FoxKit. This will open the FoxKit settings dashboard. Look for the pop-up feature on the FoxKit's power list. There, you'll find an option to enable or disable the feature. Set it as active. To ensure that mobile visitors see the pop-up, check the Show on Mobile option. You can choose the pop-up type you want depending on your goal. Use Collect Leads pop-up to collect your customer's email with a subscribe form. Use Give a Discount Code pop-up to offer a promotion with a discount code displayed directly in the pop-up. Use Subscribe to get discount pop-up encourages users to subscribe to your mailing list or SMS marketing in exchange for a discount. Use Announcement pop-up to share important news with your customers with a call to action button. Here, I will select the Subscribe to get discount pop-up as an example. Scroll down to the Content Settings section and add needed text in the provided space such as title, description, discount code, button label, email placeholder, and thank you message. Regarding the discount code field, you need to enter a code that matches one of the existing discount codes in your Shopify discounts. With the discount code picker feature, you can easily search for and select a discount code from the list of available options in Shopify. Move to the data collection section. You can choose where you would like to store the subscriber information. Check Shopify customers list if you want to store data directly within Shopify. Check FoxKit subscribers list to store the data within the FoxKit app. Use the Add Integration button to connect to other email marketing or CRM tools. Now, navigate to the Design tab to edit the pop-up appearance. You can choose from pre-designed pop-up templates to quickly create a professional-looking pop-up. Then, customize the colors for the background, text, button, and teaser to ensure they match your store's branding. You can either add an image to your pop-up by clicking the Add Image button to make it more engaging.
Your store needs to stand out and tell your brand story right. And it's never easier to level up your pages with Foxify. Design fast with stunning and high-converting templates of any page type. Create and use customizable Foxify sections anywhere on your page, anywhere in your store. Translate your pages to multiple languages instantly right in Foxify. Ensure your pages are performing at their best by receiving data about your customers. Grow massive sales without using third-party apps. And create pages that convert with advanced tools. It's not just the tool, Foxicom team is behind it all. Your success is our priority. Foxify, build right, win high.
And lastly, you can edit the display settings for your pop-up. Let's start by looking at the Trigger Open Automatically settings. This section controls when your pop-up appears on the screen. You can select from various options. After page loaded, the pop-up will appear as soon as the page finishes loading. After specific time, you can set a custom delay, like 5 seconds before the pop-up is triggered. If you prefer to display the pop-up after the user scrolls down, select the After Scrolling Down option. For exit intent pop-ups, choose User is leaving the website. This option is great for reducing cart abandonment, but note that it only works on desktops. On mobile, it will be shown after the page is loaded. If you don't want the pop-up to open automatically, select the Don't Open Automatically option. You'll need to enable the teaser button so users can manually open it. Next, we'll configure how often the pop-up should appear for the same user by selecting an interval under Repeat Open Automatically. For instance, choosing Every Day will show the pop-up to returning visitors once per day unless they've already converted. Now, let's decide where to show the pop-up under Displays On. Select the All Pages option if you want the pop-up to appear across all pages on your site. If you want the pop-up to appear exclusively on the home page, choose the Home Page Only option. For more control, select Custom Pages. This allows you to show the pop-up on the specific pages that meet all the rules or any rules you set. You can set conditions based on page type or page URL. For page URL, don't forget the protocol http://https:// is equal to, add the page type or page URL you want the pop-up to appear on. For example, page type is equal to product pages to display the pop-up on all product pages of your website. Is not equal to, add the page type or page URL you do not want the pop-up to appear on. Contains, add the page type or page path segment value to display the pop-up on URLs that contain that value. For example, page URL contains all to display the pop-up on page URLs that have the word all. Does not contain, add the page type or page path segment to exclude the pop-up on certain a page type or URLs that contain that value. Next, let's talk about the teaser button settings. The teaser button allows users to manually open the pop-up whenever they want. Enable the Show Teaser Button option to activate this feature. Then, you can choose when to show it. You have the option to show after the pop-up has opened for the first time, or always show the teaser button for easy access. You can also customize where the teaser button appears on the screen. Select left or right for its position. Finally, edit the title to customize the text on the teaser button. For example, you could use Get a Discount. Click Save once you've done it. And that's it. You've now learned how to set up a discount pop-up by using Foxkit Boost Sales for your Shopify store. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. If you like our video, make sure you give the video a thumbs up and hit subscribe so you won't miss any other future tutorials. Thanks for watching.